Hello friends, we are going to discuss about metabolism along with role of yog on metabolism. Before moving ahead, just imagine this analogy which is much closer to metabolism. Imagine a factory that manufactures hundreds of products by using raw materials, and this factory operates 24 hours a day and can speed up or slow down production at moments according to the demand for its products. The factory generates only environmentally safe waste and can repair itself when the need arises. The products manufactured in this factory can be found in any grocery store of the city. This sounds like a utopian city of the future. A utopian city which is well organized and like a pleasant dream. A dream we all commonly share. Now imagine, in our body, billions of such factories, grocery stores, and utopian cities are operating just like this in every cell. Each cell has own factory, but the cells cannot function alone. They rely on one another for supply of raw materials, waste removal, and energy generation. The whole process for supply of raw materials, waste removal, and the energy generation is a form of metabolism. The manufactured products of the cell are stored in different organs of the body as the grocery store of the city. Whole body functioning, maintenance, and organization is like a utopian city. Now the question is, what is the role of metabolism in our body? First point, it plays an important role at digestion level. It breaks down eatables into a micro size that can be absorbed by the intestine and the cells. This is accomplished by metabolic processes. Second point, blood circulation. For flow of blood cells from one place to another place, energy is required. That energy comes from metabolism. Third point is excretion. For removal of wastage like passing stool, urination, and sweating, energy is required. That energy supplies by metabolic process. Consider it. Due to loose motion or too much sweating, we feel exhausted. That is due to loss of energy. Fourth point is thermoregulation. For maintaining internal body temperature, energy is required. For example, in winter season, metabolic rate increases for maintaining the body temperature with environment, which is also fulfilled by metabolism. Fifth point is energy. In our body, whenever energy is required, either for formation of new cells or work, that energy and material is provided by metabolism. Now the question, what is metabolism? The chemical processes by which cells produce the matter and energy needed to sustain life is known as metabolism. Basically, it has two processes. First process is catabolism. In this, energy is released as well as larger molecules are broken down into smaller molecules as per need. Along with this, heat is generated, body does its work and also removes some waste products. Second process is anabolism. In this, energy is required. Energy and catabolic products are used in this process for maintenance and growth of body. Anabolism is responsible for synthesis in body. Old age has catabolic dominance. That's why healing process becomes slow. Early age has anabolic dominance. That's why healing process and growth occurs very well. Before elaborating metabolic rate, we will be familiar with myths of metabolic rate. Generally, people preach that eating on time is a must-have habit to rectify our system. Otherwise, metabolic rate will be disturbed. We must remember taking food on the basis of biological need is a healthy habit, not on the basis of mechanical time. Normally, our society predominantly discusses that body weight affects our metabolic rate, but it is not true and is a famous myth. Body weight is the outcome of our whole metabolic rate as per internal circumstances of the body. So, for modifying the body weight, firstly, modifying internal circumstances of the body is crucial than the focusing on body weight. Third point, food. Majority of the people think that taking wholesome food on time makes them healthy. They are not aware about real hunger, thereby not understanding what is the genuine need of them regarding nutrition and health. Compulsive eating either for test or due to habit, assuming that they will be healthy. Fourth and major point, thyroid. Commonly, thyroid treated as a superstar of metabolic rate. It means that whole metabolic rate is depends on the thyroid gland. In real, thyroid gland is just a part of metabolic rate and not the whole of it. Besides thyroid gland, there are various other factors also which affects the metabolic rate. Now, we will be familiar about real base of metabolic rate. Metabolic rate depends on the body's need at that moment as per internal circumstances of the body, which is affected by either internal or external factors. Metabolic rate changes because when internal or external circumstances will change, then bodily needs will change definitely. What are the needs of our body? First one is the transformation of raw materials into substances by which body is made. Continuously growth and the maintenance of the body parts is going on in the body. For that, whatever is required is supplied by metabolism, and that requirement is determined by the body. Second major need of the body is energy. Energy to perform work for any movement or activity either inside or outside of the body. What is metabolic rate? The transformation rate occurs between matter and energy per unit time inside body is termed as metabolic rate. High metabolic rate means transformation rate is higher than body need due to any abnormalities. And low metabolic rate means transformation rate is lower than body needs due to any abnormalities. If transformation rate is equal to bodily needs, then metabolic rate is healthy and you will be healthy. For example, you can see in this image an obese cell. A person who is suffering from obesity, that person's cells will be like this. In this, you are seeing that yellow color. That is too much extra fat which is available outside from the cycle of metabolism of cell. Just as the weight accumulated in cell and increases the size of cell also. You can see in this downside image, when obesity reduces, then cell size as well as accumulation of fat also reduce. This is possible when accumulated fat will be consumed by increasing metabolic rate. What is the role of yogic techniques in changing metabolic rate? We will discuss in part 2 of this series, that is Metabolism and Yoga part 2. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe our channel for next updates, give your comments and share this video for awareness about yoga.